Snakes can be big or small, but the giant ones really capture our imaginations. And it turns out snakes are actually really, really good at growing huge. From anacondas to reticulated pythons to super-sized serpents of the distant past, giant snakes have evolved over and over with a surprising variety of lifestyles. But big snakes can be tough to study, leaving open questions about how they get so big or just how big they can get. So let's take a tour through the biggest snakes of all time and explore what it takes to make a super-sized serpent. The first stop on our giant snake tour is the Amazon rainforest, home to green anacondas. Big female anacondas can be more than 6 meters long and 100 kilograms, making them the world's heaviest snakes. Anacondas belong to the family Boidae. Like most boas, they're native to the Americas and they give live birth. Unlike most boas, anacondas are semi-aquatic, spending most of their time in the rivers and swamps of the Amazon. Determining exactly how big these snakes can get is tricky. There are lots of stories of 10 or 20 meter long anacondas, but it can be tough to separate truth from tall tales. It's just plain hard to measure a giant snake. Typically, you'd want to stretch the snake straight alongside a tape measure or run a string along its body and then measure the string. But big snakes don't love sitting still while someone fusses with them. They're very wiggly and very capable of defending their personal space, especially when they are that big. I am not volunteering. When it comes to wild snakes, size estimates are often based on skin, typically removed from a dead snake. But there's a problem. Snake skins are pretty stretchy. Herpetologists have found that when skinning a snake, even if they're as careful as possible, the skin can stretch 20% or more, creating the illusion of a much longer snake. Other times, a snake's size is measured by eyeballing it, which is notoriously unreliable. One account from 1937 by zoologist Hyatt Verrill tells of a group of explorers who stumbled upon a coiled anaconda in Guyana. Various group members with lots of snake experience estimated the snake was at least 9 meters long. But when they measured it, sadly after killing it, it turned out to be a more reasonable 6 meters. Even for experts, it's hard to estimate the size of a coiled snake. Another story comes from 19th century writer Walter Savage Lander, who spotted an anaconda in a river in Brazil. Based on the thickness of the snake's body, he surmised it must be at least 30 meters long. When his group got the snake out of the water and measured it, again, after killing it, it was only 5.5 meters long. The body had appeared extra thick because the snake had just swallowed a deer. Oops! Probably the largest reliably documented record comes from herpetologist William Lamar, who measured an anaconda at an impressive 7.6 meters long, or 25 feet. A snake that big faces some big challenges. Larger animals need more food, for example, and a big reptile takes longer to warm up its cold-blooded body. But there are also benefits to being big. For one thing, not many predators will mess with a snake that big. A big body also holds on to heat better once it is warmed up. And a big snake has access to food that smaller predators can't handle. Anacondas have been documented eating full-grown deer, capybaras, and even croc-like caimans, which can all be 50 kilograms or more. The perks of being gigantic are clearly worth it because anacondas aren't the only super-sized snakes out there. Reticulated pythons are famously large snakes, but they're not alone. Several species of python are known to reach 6 meters or more, including reticulated, Burmese, rock, and scrub pythons. While anacondas are semi-aquatic, big pythons have a variety of habits. Crawling on the ground, swimming in the water, even climbing trees, it helps that pythons are much slimmer than anacondas. Pythons belong to the family Pythonidae. Unlike boas, these snakes are egg layers and live in the Eastern Hemisphere, including Asia, Africa, and Australia. Like anacondas, there are some questionable stories of super-sized pythons. One popular tale comes from museum collector Harry Raven, who tells of a 10-meter-long reticulated python from Indonesia. But herpetologists have pointed out that there isn't much evidence to support this claim, and some of the story details don't quite line up, so this could be another case of a mismeasured snake. For a while, the record for longest snake belonged to Colossus, a reticulated python at the Pittsburgh Zoo, reportedly almost 9 meters long. But a 2012 study documented dug up the records from the museum that received the snake's skeleton after its death, and their official measurements had Colossus at just over 6 meters. That's big, but not quite as colossal as claimed. The biggest reliable account seems to be Samantha, a reticulated python from the Bronx Zoo, who was 7.9 meters long, or about 26 feet. Of course, these are rare cases. Most big snakes are a measly 5 meters or less. Saying pythons can reach 7 meters is kind of like saying humans can reach 7 feet tall. Technically true, but how often do you run into Shaq? And it's not just about the age of the snake. Contrary to what you might have heard, snakes don't grow forever. If snakes live long enough, they tend to settle at a maximum size. Instead, a snake's size seems to be determined by how good they had it when they were young. A 2008 study examined growth in Australian water pythons and found the snakes that got more food in their first year of life grew quickly and ended up bigger as adults. The researchers called this the silver spoon effect. The biggest snakes are the ones lucky enough to have a healthy childhood. But before we get to number three, it's time for a quick break.
This SciShow video is supported by Incogni, the tool to help you fight against spam, identity theft, and personal data breaches. Incogni's mission is to stop your data from being scattered all over the place, so you can think about way more fun stuff than that. See, there are these data brokers that can collect and sell your personal information, like really important stuff from social security numbers to emails or other login credentials. And that is where Incogni steps in. They'll request that data brokers remove your personal data. You can take your personal data back and get 60% off an annual Incogni plan using the code SciShow at incogni.com/SciShow, or click the link in the description. And this is a fully automated service, so everything just gets taken care of. You don't have to set any reminders or monitor any reports. You just live your life as if this issue doesn't exist because you've got your very own cyber team. Now, not all crime fighters are for everyone. Maybe you're more of a Batman guy or a Wonder Woman stan, so Incogni offers a 30-day money-back guarantee so you can try out their style and get a full refund if you aren't happy with the service. And if you are happy, you can keep their protection for years to come.
For even more giant snakes, we turn to the fossil record. Metsoidae is a family of extinct snakes, separate from boas and pythons, but with similar anatomy, and some of them grew at least as big as the largest modern snakes. Metsoid fossils are mainly found in southern continents, including Africa, Asia, Australia, and South America. These fossils are mostly just vertebrae, so there's a lot we don't know about their lifestyles. One study of rare metsoid skulls from Australia found that their anatomy is similar to pythons known to swim or burrow underground. So, metsoids might have had a variety of habits like pythons do. Now, measuring living snakes is tough, but it's a whole lot harder when all you have are a handful of bones. Fortunately, scientists have found that certain proportions of snake skull and backbones correlate with full body length. So, with some precise fossil measurements and comparisons with living snakes, paleontologists can estimate how long ancient snakes were. These measurements put some metsoids at around 5 meters long, such as Matsoia madagascariensis, which lived in Madagascar alongside dinosaurs in the late Cretaceous period, over 66 million years ago. A more recent example is Wonambi neracortensis from Australia, which lived during the Ice Age, so recently that it might have coexisted with early humans. Even bigger was Gigantophis from northern Africa, around 50 million years ago. The most up-to-date measurements put it at nearly 7 meters or 23 feet. Fun fact, Gigantophis used to be the largest known metsoid. It's not anymore. More on that later. Giant snake bones aren't just impressive, they give us some insight into how these snakes get so big. Generally speaking, longer snakes have more vertebrae, but giant snakes don't follow this pattern. They're not just long, they're also big-boned. The biggest snakes have a unique growth strategy. That strategy isn't fully understood. We know they can grow quickly in the right circumstances, like those pythons we mentioned, but giant snakes also tend to continue growing for a longer time than other snakes, well into adulthood. So a super growth style seems to have evolved in anacondas, pythons, and perhaps also metsoids, and this next group of supersized extinct snakes. So far, we've talked about giant snakes on land, in trees, and in rivers. Well, there also used to be giant snakes in the ocean. Paleophyidae is a family of extinct sea sea snakes. Their fossils, again, mostly vertebrae, are well known from deposits of the ancient Tethys Sea, which once existed in parts of modern Africa, Asia, and Europe. These fossils are found in ancient ocean sediments alongside fossil fish and dugongs, and they also have similar anatomy to modern sea snakes. Their vertebrae are tall and narrow, and their ribs angled more downward than outward. These features gave paleophids tall and narrow bodies like today's sea snakes, great for propelling themselves through the water. The smallest paleophids were just little guys, less than a meter long, but the biggest was the aptly named Paleophis colosseus, hailing from what's now Mali during the Eocene, approximately 45 million years ago. Based on the proportions of the vertebrae, this species is estimated to have grown at least 8 meters or 26 feet, and possibly as big as 12 meters or 40 feet. The Eocene was a great time to be a giant sea snake. The water was warm, full of food, and empty of predators. This wasn't long after the Cretaceous mass extinction, which not only wiped out most of the dinosaurs, but also lots of big marine predators like mosasaurs, plesiosaurs, and giant sea turtles. This means the Tethys Sea was lacking in big threats and competition, which might have been a key factor that allowed paleophids to reach their impressive sizes. Finally, the part you've been waiting for, the biggest snakes of all time. Yes, there are ancient snakes even larger than the ones we've already mentioned. And it's not even close. In 2009, scientists described a new fossil species named Titanoboa cerrejonensis. Its fossils come from the Paleocene epoch of Colombia around 60 million years ago. As the name suggests, it's a member of the boa family, like anacondas. Its fossil remains, lots of vertebrae and some skull bones, are truly enormous. Comparing these bones to modern boas, researchers calculated an incredible total body size of around 14 meters, give or take a few. That's 46 feet long! And this wasn't just a single unusually large individual. The fossils come from several individuals of this size. Titanoboa was regularly reaching sizes longer than a school bus. Since it was discovered, Titanoboa has been the undisputed biggest snake of all, until recently. In 2024, paleontologists described a new set of gigantic fossil vertebrae, this time from the Eocene epoch of India around 47 million years ago. This snake is a matsoid, and they named it Vasuki indicus after the Hindu mythical serpent Vasuki. From the size of its vertebrae, the researchers estimated Vasuki was either between 11 and 12 meters long or between 14 and 15 meters long, depending on which technique they used. That puts Vasuki in the same size range as Titanoboa, meaning two different families of snakes reached these unbelievable sizes. But despite their similar size, these snakes lived very different lives. Researchers suspect Titanoboa was a fish eater. Its skull is similar to modern fish-eating snakes, and its fossils are found alongside ancient river sediments and fossils of large fish. Meanwhile, Vasuki comes from ancient swamp marsh sediments, similar to some modern big pythons, and its skeletal anatomy is most similar to python species that hang out mainly on land. So just like there are many ways to be a big snake today, there was more than one way to be a super snake in the distant past. But one big thing these snakes do have in common: they liked it hot. During the Paleocene and Eocene epochs, the Earth had a particularly warm climate. And these two ancient snakes, just like all giant snakes past and present, lived in or near the tropics. Having a warm habitat is helpful, maybe even necessary, for these snakes to warm up their enormous bodies. Titanoboa and Vasuki probably benefited from all the things that help big snakes get big. Like modern big snakes, they inhabited very warm habitats. Like those ancient sea snakes, they lived not long after a mass extinction wiped out many big predators. Like those water pythons, they surely had plenty of food. And like other giant snakes, they probably had a souped-up growth style. Giant animals aren't just physically impressive, they teach us about the upper limits of life on Earth. With more research, we might discover new secrets behind the survival of giant snakes, and who knows, we might someday find even bigger snakes.